Good morning. Now I welcome you to yet another session of our Oedipus. Still we are going to the climax of the story. In the last previous class we totally was worried about the situation of our Oedipus. And now in meanwhile another Stasimon appearing in a chorus. And now give you that you understand the relevance of chorus, how does a chorus act in an epic drama. Chorus, if I have any power of prophecy or skill in knowing things, then by the Olympian deities, you Citharo, Netumaros, moon will surely know that Oedipus pays tribute to you and his native land, both as his mother and his nurse. What does Chorus say? Chorus says, if Chorus has power of prophecy, if the Chorus as a team has power of foretelling the truth, what happens? They are ready to communicate what is going to happen. And Olympian deities like Citharon, Timaros, moon will sure. Tomorrow's moon means within short time, if Chorus has the power to communicate as a prophecy, they would communicate shortly within a moment or by next day, all people come to know the real truth, what is going to happen and what was going to happen. Both his mother and his niece, that our choral dance and song acknowledge you because you are so pleasing to our king. All the people now standing inside the palace. You, my dear people, you are very dear to our king. You please understand his situation. Now what type of miseries is coming across? You people who are lovable and dear to our king, please listen. And also Chorus addressing God Phoebus. God Phoebus, who cried to you, may our song will you to delight, who gave birth to you, my child, which one of the immortal gods bore you to the father Pan, who roams in mountainside? Was it some daughter of Apollo, the god who loves the country field, perhaps Cilian royal king? The chorus in all together, from right to left and left to right, when they come stand still in the middle of the stage, they tell, oh, this is the total benediction by the god. It is the fate of Oedipus, or it is fate of all human beings like this. So we have to surrender ourselves to God. All of a sudden chorus as a group singing now vanishes. Fourth episode begins by line 11330. All right, 13330. So we have to refer. Now Oedipus looking out away from the palace. Again looking out away from the palace, addressing the public. You people elders, although I have never seen the man, Oedipus addressing the public and telling, though I had sent so many people, the person who did this, reported this crime, not yet returned. I want to see and you want to know the truth, but we don't get. You elders, we have been looking for the long time now. That man has not reached, whom we had sent so many soldiers here and there to find and discover him. But he is not brought. If I had to guess, I think I see him. He is coming here. But my mind says, slowly, slowly, he is coming now. The moment, the sooner he reaches here, we will come to know the real truth. He is coming here. He looks very old, as an appropriate. If he is one that I know, the people coming with him, all the people who are behind him coming to the palace, are my own people, my own courtiers, my own servants. But if you have seen him before, if you have seen this man earlier, you should tell me. You will recognize him better than I will. Oedipus is totally perplexed. And addressing the people, if you know this man very clearly, you understand and you inform me, because you are the people who are familiar to this man, so let him come. We will find a resolution what the real action to be taken. Chorus leader, yes, I recognize the man, there is no doubt. Chorus leader very apparently saying, no doubt at all, he is the man, no doubt, he worked for the lies. During the time of lies, our former king, this man was under his servitude. This man was as a servant, a trusty shepherd, underline. So this is the man everybody knows, because this man was a shepherd to Laius, who was our former king, and our servant and old shepherd, Oedipus. Stranger from Corinth, let me first ask you, is this the man you mentioned? To asking the old people, and also to the Corian, the man who now reported Polybus died, now he is here, all right? Then asking this man from Corinth, all right? Oh man, is this man that you mentioned who gave you child on the mountain peak and the valley? Is this man strange from Corinth, the stranger from Corinth, please? Let me first ask you, is this man you mentioned now, messenger? Yes, my lord, he is. He's the man you see in front of you. Now he's standing. Oedipus, you old man over here, look at me. Out of control, Oedipus is telling this new man, shepherd, asking you, old man, look at me. Now answer what I ask. I am going to ask you some questions. You have to answer me. Otherwise, I will cut your head. Some time ago, did you work for Laius? Did you work for Laius, former king here? Servant, all right, the messenger. Did you work for the servant? Did you work for Laius in the olden time here? You old man, look at me. Servant, yes. I worked as a slave. But I was not bought. during the time of Greek tragedies and earlier time of Greece, so many people who are taken birth in low caste will be taken with price. They will be bought by the masters. So this man telling, I was not bought by Laius. He did not pay for me, but I was the man here. I was not bought. Old man, now look at me. I was not bought. I grew up in his house. From my childhood, I was there in the palace. How did you leave? What was the work you did? What was the work you were doing during the time of Laius? Servant, most of my life I have spent looking after sheep. I was a shepherd for the king. Lot of flocks of sheep was there, and I was as a shepherd controlling the sheep. Where? In any particular place, area that you walked? Servant, most of my life, Oedipus, where? Servant, on Citharon, the neighboring island, neighboring lands, to the frontier place of our country, I used to take the sheep and controlling the sheep all the mountain valleys. Do you know if you came across this man answering anywhere up? Now showing the messenger, asking the servant, have you seen this man anywhere? Do you remember this man anywhere? Servant, doing what? What man do you mean? Oedipus, the man over here, this one, look at him, this one. Have you ever run into him? Have you come across with him? Any idea about this man? Messenger, my lord, that is surely right now. Have you ever run to him? Means, have you come across him? Servant telling, right now I can't see. Not now, I do not remember, but slightly remember him. Messenger telling, my lord, that surely not surprising. Such people will tell like that, because I communicated with this man long years back. So it may not be sure that he is remembering me. Let me refresh his failing memory. Though he is old now, he has a failing memory. So I cannot remind, but I will try. I think he will remember all too well the time we spend around Citharon. Then I will try to remind him about our deeds and action during the time when I was with him in the mountain valley of Citharon. He had two flocks of sheep. I had one. He had a group of sheep, but I had only one group. I was with him for 6 months at a stretch. It is not easy that he can easily forget me, because I was with him for 6 months at a stretch. Then he would definitely remember me. From early spring until the autumn season in winter, I would drive my ship down my folds and take it to pens and lies owned. Is that what happened, what I have just said? Immediately after 6 months, I would go to my native place, and this man used to take the sheep to the pen, to the yard where lies owns servant. You spoke the truth, but it was long ago. You are telling the real truth that I know, but I know you, but it is many years ago. Stranger, all right then. Now tell me, if you remember, how you gave me a child, underline. Now the first statement is coming. Now you try to recall. One that day, that mission day, that you gave me a small child in my hand, you remember? An infant boy for me to raise my own foster son. You demanded me, requested me to foster a child, to bring up a child. For that statement, you gave me an infant boy, that you remember? Servant, what? Why ask about that now? Why do you ask now this matter here? Messenger, this man here, me friend, was that young child back then. That time you gave a child, no. That child is this man, showing Oedipus. Servant, damn you. Can't you keep quiet about it? Why do you tell this matter here? Why do you tell this matter here? Why can't you keep it quiet, that in silence? Oedipus, hold on, old man. Don't criticize him. You have no right to criticize this man, messenger. You tell the plain truth only. Otherwise, his shape will be different. What you have said is more objectionable than his account. Servant, my noble master, what have I done wrong? I don't know what mistake did I do, my lord. Please forgive me. I have not done any mistake. What, my lord? Oedipus, you did not tell us of infant boy, the one he asked about. He asked about an infant boy whom you gave to this man. Do you remember that? Answer that question first. Servant, that is what he says, but he knows nothing. A useless busybody. Oedipus, if you want to tell us of your own free will, if you are still hiding the truth, I will have to take force to make you open your mouth in the correct way. So do not allow me to do so. You should reveal all the truth. If you won't tell us of your own free will, once we start to hurt you, you will talk definitely. When once I try to force you, you will have to talk. By all the gods, don't torture an old man. I am an old man, my lord. Please don't torture me like this. Don't, please, my lord, don't torture me. One of you there, tie up this man, fellow hands. Hey, come here. Anybody, soldiers here, come here, servant. These arrest him, bind him, put him in prison. We will ask him later. One of you there, tie up his fellow's hands. Why are you doing this, my lord? It is too much for me. I am an old man. I cannot bear this. Don't arrest me. Put in the prison. Why are you doing this? It is much for me. What is you want me? You ask me. I am ready to tell anything. Please, don't arrest me. Don't torture me. The child he mentioned, did you give to him? That is the first question. Did you give a child to this man many years ago? You tell me the truth. I did. How I wish I would die that day. I now wish if I had died earlier, it would have been done best. But real thing, master, I admit, I gave a boy to this man. I did, Oedipus. Well, you are going to die if you don't speak the truth. If you do not, unless you reveal the truth, we are going to kill you. And if I do, there is a greater chance that I would have been killed. It seems to me man is trying to stall. Anyway, he is going to hide so many things. Anyway, we will have to make some forces on him. Servant, no, I am not. I am already told I did give him the child. Underline. What is to say more? What do you want to know something about from me? Already I told you, I gave a child to this man. Where did you get it? My second question. Where did you get it? Where did you get the child? Did it come from your home or somewhere else? Oedipus asking, where did you get the child from? Is it from your any relative's house or from somewhere else? Servant, no, my lord, it is not mine. It is not my relative's child. It is not my child. I got it from someone. Which of your citizen, where home was it? Whose home was it? You revealed the truth. From where did you get? From whose house you got it? In the name of God, my lord, don't ask me. Don't ask me such a question, please. No more questions. Save this old man's life. If I have to ask again, then you will die. Answer me. From where did you get the child? Servant. The child was born in Lys home, the king, former king's home, I got the child, you underline. Servant, with no other way but revealing the truth, I got a child from the former king, this palace, my lord. From a slave or from a relative of this? From a slave from this home or from any servant's hands or from relatives of his? Alas, what I am about to state is very horrible for me. And I am about to hear it, but nonetheless I have to know this. If I must know, they said the child was his, but your wife inside the palace is one who could best tell you what was going on. My lord, I am very innocent, don't kill me. As far as I know, Lys gave me the child. If you ask your present wife would tell you much more than me, that she can reveal you more, so many things relating to this. I am very innocent. Please save my life. You mean she gave the child to you? Yes, my lord. Why did she do that? So I would kill it. She told me that I should kill the child on the mountain valley, but I did not do. That wretched woman was the mother. Servant, yes, she was afraid of dreadful prophecies from Delphi oracles. This woman was afraid of so many prophecies. So she entrusted me with the child that child should be killed on the mountain valley. That was the reason. What sort of the prophecies you mean? The story went during the time everywhere in the market corner, street corner. The child would kill his father. That was the message, prophecy, the lady God. So in order to avoid such incidents, child killing the father, she might have thought to abandon the child somewhere, killing body or carcass, putting to the birds. Oedipus, if that was true, why did you give the child to this old man? If the prophecy was there, if the lady told you like then instead of killing the child, why did you give the child to this man? I pitied the boy, my lord. When I see his innocent face, I could not kill him, master. I thought he would take the child off to foreign land when he was with me. Then I thought this man would take the child to another country and live somewhere. I was not ready to kill the innocent child. Where he was from, he rescued him only to save him the greatest grief all. If you are the one this man says you are, you know the birth carried awful fate. In the world, this is happening, and in order to avoid a real fate, I was forced to do. After revealing the truth, listening to this matter from the servant, Oedipus totally collapsed. Oedipus, so it all came true. It is so clear now. Underline. It is so clear now. Underline. This is called now understanding the real theme and the plot of the story. Oedipus totally staggered. Oedipus totally shattered by the ill fates in his life. Oh, light. He calls that very important passage. Oh, light. This may be the final light for me. Oh, light. Let me look at you one final time. He opens his very big, all right eyes and look at all the ways and all the areas in a frantic way, understanding and telling, addressing the light. This is the final light I am going to see. O man who stands to reveal the Christ by birth. I am the man who is not eligible to see light from this moment. Because I am cursed by the birth. I am cursed by my birth. Cursed by all my family. Cursed by murder where I should not kill. So this day I am going to close my eyes. From this day onwards, I will never see light because I am the person who is really penetrated and what is called suffered a lot. And not merely the birth, but my own family cursed me and my own family abandoned me somewhere. And oh light, from this moment I am not eligible to see you in the better way. So then telling, Oedipus moves into the palace in a very irritable condition, and what he finds in the future, he is coming to later. And now we are marching towards the fourth Stasimon by chorus. which will give you a very lengthy gap to be filled by Stasimon or fourth Stasimon by the chorus. And this chorus Stasimon with the real, gap filling between the communication of the king and the public, and not merely Oedipus, but also somewhere this listened by our Jocasta. Jocasta now also understanding everything is out of control, everything collapsed. Now there is nothing but, there is no other way but to end her life. And what a tragedy now he goes on. This is Stasimon again telling you, in order to avoid your concentration, because wherever we find a tragic hero falls down, this is the scene from a very great noble place, noble position. Oedipus fell down as a noble man. This falling down is the real, the plot of epic and plot of tragedy. And now this catharsis, what type of purgating the soul that we always understand. When we go for movies, I do remember one movie earlier, so many years ago. If you have free time, you watch that. No people can go out of the auditorium of the cinema theater without tears. If you sincerely watch from the beginning to the end, cinema called Agash Dude. All right, so that cinema, abandoning the children, almost 3 to 4 children, that mother who is suffering from cancer is going to die, and husband, father of children already died. It was presented by, directed by C.B. Malayil, a Malayali director. So many people who are there in the cinema theater, crying. And after 2-3 more days, this crying, what you call sadness, fell through the tears, might have given them a type of consolation. This type of consolation, after crying, after understanding, after spitting the tears from our soul will be purified. This is the technology what we apply, what is called catharsis theory or purification of the soul. This is maintained in all tragedies. That is one of the examples called Agash Dude, a Malayalam movie that you people have to watch when you get free time. Immediately after watching the cinema Agash Dude, you will get a somewhat sad, melancholic mood. But within short time, slowly, your mind, your soul will take the former position, and you will be trying to enjoy life. This type of purification of your soul is called catharsis, as that you referred by Aristotle. So this catharsism is now going on here. This is the time where total noble position, our king now fell down. Understand his mistakes. Now Jocasta the queen also understanding, she is a queen, now also going to fall down, and the tragedy goes to happen. In between, chorus appearing and tell you to deviate your attention to another world where you should find who is this Oedipus, why he was abandoned, why this country is suffering from plague, why this is happening now, who is responsible for these activities. All these have been discussed so far. Now reaching to the moment, Stasimon, our fourth Stasimon, chorus telling is in between a gap to tell you the real truth and what is the catastrophe, what is the denouement. This is a technical word we call denouement. Last scene of the drama is going to happen. That is called Exodus. Or that we call last stage, we call. Then we will understand. Sometimes 2-3 days or 2-4 weeks, you will be sad, you will be melancholic, you will be unhappy. but slowly your mind, your soul will take a former position, then you will be happy. This type of purification is meant for Greek tragedies, what is called catharsism. So to understand what is Stasimon, next day we will face you with the climax of the story. Till that moment, thank you.